All right, on this tab and the next one, we will be doing applications of elasticity. This particular application is monopoly pricing. We have a diagram that's similar to the one we had before with the linear demand curve. Here's the revenue rectangle if the price is set at 55. We have the controls to set the price intercept and the quantity intercept. I have them set a little bit differently. So let's just look at what's new. We have something now called unit cost, and you can control the unit cost here, raise it or lower it, and the area under the unit cost gives what's called variable cost. So if you net the revenue rectangle from the revenue rectangle, if you net the variable cost, you get this difference, which is this rectangle. That difference is called producer surplus. That's what the monopolist is trying to maximize. And incidentally, every firm is really a monopolist in some market, perhaps a small market, but some market. So this is kind of a realistic first pass at how should a monopolist set its price. So let's begin by looking at what happens in this region when we raise price a little bit. And note, we are in a region where let me actually start with a lower price here so we can do the analysis a little better. So let's start over here. Now we're in a region where the elasticity of demand is inelastic. Demand is inelastic. And in such a region, it is definitely more profitable to raise price. So look what happens when I raise price a little bit. Revenue actually goes up and costs go down. Revenue goes up because demand is inelastic, and when you raise price when demand is inelastic, you actually increase revenue. Costs go down because you're selling less. So when demand is inelastic, it's definitely a good idea to raise price. And now I'm going to keep on raising price in the region of inelastic demand. What's happening to profitability? We've now hit unitary elastic demand. Can we get more profit if we keep raising price? The answer is yes. And I've been saying profit where I mean surplus. Producer surplus and profit are related concepts. So let's see if we keep going. And we're getting probably... Oh, now we went too far. So the profit maximum, get to 50... At price equal to 54, that looks pretty good. And I'm going to guess that... we can do better. 53. Looks like 53 is the profit maximum. You'll recall that when we had the revenue maximum, that happened at the point where elasticity was unity. The surplus maximum occurs where this net rectangle is biggest. And we're going to look at the conditions that determine that. At the surplus maximizing point, marginal revenue, which is the change in revenue with respect to output, and you can figure that out by using the chain rule, so it's the first times the derivative of the second, which is price, plus the second times the derivative of the first, which is Q times dp to Q. That's what marginal revenue is. If you factor out the P, what's left over is 1 plus 1 over... the demand elasticity. So here's marginal revenue. At the surplus maximum, marginal revenue equals marginal cost, which is this per unit cost. In this case, it's $12. So at the surplus maximum, marginal revenue equals marginal cost. If you rearrange the algebra, you get this result. The relative markup of price over marginal cost, so price minus marginal cost over P, is equal to minus 1 over the demand elasticity, and that is called the Lerner Index. And here we have a little note. Let me see if I can scroll down a little bit and you can read the note a little better. It says the Lerner Index is the relative markup of price over marginal cost, which measures the firm's market power.